Hello everyone, Darek Vos here from Caliathletics, and today I'll be helping you to understand how to train calisthenic skills. So let's get it started. I have already recorded a video about skills training methods that you can check here, but I have not talked yet about how exactly should we train with progressions and attempts to get the most out of our workouts. First of all, if you are a beginner or intermediate, it will be definitely worth to start with basic calisthenics exercises and weighted calisthenics in order to build strength. It won't suddenly make you achieve all of these skills, but it may indirectly really help you increase the strength that is necessary for chosen progression or even let you move to more difficult one. Example, you cannot do a dragonfly and even a tuck dragonfly seems impossible to perform. Focus on strengthening exercises and after a month or two, get back to dragonfly training. It may happen that you will be suddenly able to do a full dragonfly negative. So rule number one, instead of working on too difficult skill, improve your strength with basic exercises and spend that time on achieving easier skills firstly. However, working only with the basic exercises will never lead you to advanced calisthenic skills such as 90 degree handstand push-up, front lever or planche, if you do not work for that particularly. This is why we should mix in our workouts all of this, the strengthening exercises, progressions and attempts. Despite progressions and strengthening exercises, implementing attempts was one of the most important parts of my workouts that helped me the most in achieving calisthenic skills really fast. With attempts method, I simply mean attempting the chosen skill or very demanding progression, even though you might be not able to perform it perfectly yet. Now that you know the basics, it is a time to share with you my personal advice on workouts with progressions. First of all, you are the one who must decide on which progression you should start with. Here, make sure that it is challenging enough, but at the same time you are able to execute perfect form. You can also combine a few progressions, but always start with the hardest one. Most of calisthenics guys recommend achieving at least 15 seconds of hold before moving to the next progression, but in my opinion, if you are able to hold it for such a long time, it simply means it doesn't challenge you enough. And you can get better results by working already with more efficient one. In that case, I would say 7 up to 10 seconds will be enough to move for the further progression. Right now, I'm going to show you an example workout based on front lever, where I'm going to put all of the training methods in one and show you exactly how would I organize that. After this, I'm going to explain you the reasons behind it. As you could see, this front lever routine that I presented you before is for really advanced calisthenics athletes, since I was performing most of the progressions and strengthening exercises in really difficult form. However, you can always adjust that to your needs. So with that being said, instead of performing, for example, the full front lever negatives, you're going to perform it with one leg or the tuck variation. So in that case, I only wanted to present you the method of programming. And right now I'm going to show you how you can adjust that to your needs if you're, for example, intermediate calisthenics athlete. As you could see, I picked up attempts firstly, then progressions, as well as strengthening exercises. The order here was very important because you always want to start with the most difficult exercise in order to be fresh and get the most out of it. After attempts, I mixed the progressions and strengthening exercises, also in difficulty order. What should you remember about is that when it comes to skills training, you should focus on high frequency and not training to overall fatigue. If you adjust the program to your needs and keep the total workout volume low, you can train skills even every day. It all depends on your current level, but if you're strong enough with the basics, you can consider working with the attempts and progressions only. Here you can perform even just a few reps, but keep the frequency high, so repeat it a few times a week, every day, or even a few times a day with the grease the groove method. However, here you should always listen to your body and observe if your regeneration and progress is on point. There are many methods to program a weak skill routine, and the one I presented to you before is just an example, and it all depends on how you organize your week schedule and many more factors. I covered three basic training methods in my previous video, and if you're interested in a fully individual approach, you can sign up for my online coaching here. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this video and will start progressing faster with your skills. If you want to know how to start calisthenics, I prepared for you a free ebook that you can download from my website, and the link is in the description. You can also check my calisthenics and weighted calisthenics program here, and that was it for today. Let me know in the comments what should I record for you in the future, and see you guys in the next video. Peace. I'm